The first movie I was so blown away by, and that you could pause any part of the film, put it in a frame, put it up on the wall, and it would be, you know, an apt piece of art. And going into, you know, this one, it was just such a thrill to be part of it, and you have a sense of, you know, how it's going to turn out because of the first one. But then to see it on the screen just blew my mind, and it completely exceeded my expectations.
We had the luxury of actually being able to engage with human beings, like either other actors or stuntmen and whatnot. So it didn't really gruel your imagination too badly, in the sense where you're trying to replace a tennis ball on the end of a stick with whatever it might eventuate to on screen. So there was still a human quality to it, and you know the green was very much background. But I think after several days, weeks spent in the one green screen studio, you start to detest the colour a bit.
Well, they were very dry to shoot them. Fortunately, you know, that was all added in later on. But it was basically one of the Athenian ships, and also the Persian ones, of course, on gimbals, which are these hydraulic rigs that move the whole boat, so you can have, you know, 200 of us up there, and the boat is moving around. So you had to, you know, lend yourself to your imagination to create the heightened sense of reality. But yeah, they did an incredible job in post, particularly when you see. I remember one shot of this Persian bomber guy, and he had to crawl up, and I'm spearing him. And there was another shot of this other guy, and he's climbing up, and below him was this concrete floor with cigarette butts and, you know, styrofoam cups, and just, you know, really dirty. And then I saw that shot in the film, and it was this picture perfect glistening ocean, and you just, you know, like, hats off to the post-production. It's incredible.
It's art, isn't it, as you say. There's a lot of artwork involved there, a lot of artists in a edit suite and a grafting. So I guess that's the fruits of their labour.
No, we did the work with that, man. That's real. But in the beginning, you know, when you know, I was probably at best sucking in a one pack when I first turned up. I thought it would be. I was like, when I saw the green screen, I thought, why can't we just have a sock around our torso and they can just CG that? You know? Oh yeah.
Has no one told you? No one's mentioned it. We're the first to tell you. Wow. How long have we got? I mean, personally, I much preferred the combat training. You know, that was a lot of fun, just running around with this fake sword, you know, and you know, actually feeling capable to some degree. Whereas compared to the gym stuff, a lot of the time we was made to feel incapable, you know, it was quite militant, which I guess in the overall helps, but at the time it's a bit like torture. It's a bit like legal torture. It's a legal form of torture. That's what it is.